from Atomic Cellar Vintage Singer, because that's what I like to do. So today I'm going to share my love of all things Blenko, Blenko glass, B-L-E-N-K-O. It's handmade right here in the USA in Milton, West Virginia, where all the good glass comes from. And they still make it today. So they started making glass back in the late 1920s, I believe. I'm going to share some of my favorite pieces with you today. I will preface this with saying I am not an expert. I'm a collector. All right, so first, this piece. This is one of the iconic water bottles. And I have two, and I'll show you the other one in just a hot minute. But this is one of the very first items. It's item number 384. So when you see a number, an ID number, like an item number, 384, the two first numbers of the year that it was first made. So this was first made in 1938. Does it mean this specific one was made in 1938? Probably not, but that's when the first one was made. If you can see, it's a double pour pitcher. This one I found when I was at Goodwill, a local Goodwill, and it was on the bottom shelf, which just goes to show, always check the bottom shelves. It was there for $4.99, and yes, I snagged it. Yes, it is not for sale, it is mine. And we actually use it. I've added this to my collection. This is an amber. Again, 384. This one's pretty cool. It's got the sticker right there. The label, the original label. Give you a close-up. There you go. So I love things when they have the labels on them. This is an earlier label, which leads me to believe that this is older rather than newer. And the labels are quite different, the new ones, and I'll show you an example of that in a minute. Okay, I'm gonna bring out some more and tell you what I know about them or what I don't know about them. Okay, so you can see that I have two of these already set up. I'm gonna add some more. So this one here is a crackle glass pitcher. It's got the applied clear handle to it. It's a big one. I have no idea as to the year, but I'm kind of thinking it's probably newer rather than older. Let's just put that right here. So pretty, right? And I have another crackle glass. I absolutely love this one. So on the bottom, you'll see on how do you identify Blenko? That's a question that's asked sometimes. So, with the exception of these that I just showed you, these do not have a pontil on the bottom because these were made from metal molds. But other Blenko pieces will have a pontil. And it looks like a little scar on the bottom. You can feel it. It almost looks like a defect. So, if you turn your vase or glass piece over on the bottom and you see this, this is actually a sign that this was hand blown. They hand blow it. If you've ever watched them do blown glass, you'll see that they break off the rod at the end. So this is Blenko. Okay, let's see what else do I have. Love this piece. This is the amber paper bag vase, and you can see now the label here is a more modern label. And again, if you turn around, you'll see the pontil on the bottom. Pontil, P-O-N-T-E-I-L. Think so. Correct me in comments if I'm wrong. I'm gonna run out of room. Okay, this big old thing. Love the cobalt blue. Big picture, and again, it's, you see the newer label on there. So it's newer rather than older. And this is heavy. A lot of people ask me, why am I obsessed with Blenko glass? Well, there's a lot of reasons. It's simple, it's heavy, it's substantial, it's made in the USA, which is always a good thing. So there's so many reasons why I love it. You know, some people love Fenton. I like Fenton. I've got some Fenton pieces. Some people love Viking. I am definitely a Blenko person. Okay, I have another piece here. Oh, you can hear the trash truck going by out there. Again, poncho marks on the bottom. It's beautiful fan vase. It's just simple. Oh, and I'm running out of room. Okay. Love this little piece here. Now, this was probably made out of a mold. I do know for a fact it is Blenko. And these are really cute. So this is a smaller one. These are the hat ice buckets. So this is more of a personal ice bucket. They're a very small bottle. I've sold bigger ones, but I decided to keep this one. And they come in all different ones, all different plain hats. They've got cowboy hats, they've got fancy hats. So if you find one of these now, you'll know what it is. And over here, ashtrays. Yes, they make ashtrays. It's amber, owl. This is a double win-win for me because I love owls and I love Blenko. This is kind of a no-brainer. My question is, how did people use these to put their cigarettes out in? That's what I don't understand. They're absolutely gorgeous. Of course, I've never smoked. All right, so I bought this from a friend of mine. It's a Blenko mushroom. It's beautiful. These are highly desirable if you find one. Okay, mushrooms are a thing. So in case you thought that a Blenko is a one-trick pony and they only make beautiful glass pitchers and things, apparently they also got into making fruit and vegetables. This is a more modern piece. You can tell again by the more recent sticker here. It's a lovely eggplant, or in some parts of the world, an aubergine. Are you impressed that I knew that? I'm gonna lay it down on the side so it doesn't fall over. Okay. I also have this gorgeous strawberry. So again, it's got the more recent sticker on it. It's just the handiwork in this. It's just amazing. Love it. Okay, I have a few more pieces to show you. So this one I bought from a friend of mine. It's tangerine. I absolutely love this one. Can't leave these out. Little ice cubes. These are the little ice cube candle hold stick holders. Love these. Gonna use these at Christmas time. Great for the holidays. I'll just put these right. I don't even know if you can see those. Okay, they're right there. Only have one of these, but I'm looking for more. These are Blenko. Also, everything's Blenko. Hello. This is Blenko Day. So this one here is beautiful olive green. There is no pontil. This was made from a mold. Running out of room. This is pretty special. I bought this for myself for my birthday, which was in August. We won't mention the year. But I went out and wanted to buy something for myself that I would not resell. This was labeled as Blenko. Now, I wasn't 100% convinced because Blanco's not known for doing medallions, but they did have guest glass artists. So after a lot of research, and talking to two appraisers who had differing opinions, whether it was Blenko or not, this was appraised by a very well-known appraiser that it is Blenko, an early Blenko piece. And it is not for sale. I absolutely love this. And yes, it's got the pontil on the bottom. Always check for your pontil mark. Sometimes if you're out somewhere, and especially like at thrift shops and whatnot, for some reason they love to slap it. Slap on their sticker right here. So do what I know irritates them, because I do it, is I peel it off to take a look. Very gently, and then I put it back. But also, I want to make sure that pontil mark is there. The next item I have to show you is a really cool paperweight Blenko. It's heavy, it's clear. It's got the label on it. And this item number is 6913. So if you remember 6913, two first numbers is the number of the year that it was first produced, so 1969. And it's a chunky. Here's a close-up. Blenko also made ashtrays, mid-century modern ashtrays. This first one is really heavy. That's a big ashtray. And we see this is a party group ashtray. There's four places for cigarettes. Again, like I said before, I can't imagine using something this gorgeous to put your cigarettes out in. This is item 703, which means it was first produced in 1970. And this is amber color. I have one more ashtray made by Blenko. This one is like a free form. They're all handmade, so they're all a little bit different. Really pretty amber. 966 is the item number, which means 1996. And it's kind of amoeba shape, amber color. Again, I use mine in my bathroom to kind of hold my trinkets and stuff. And makes a great display item. Don't need to be a smoker. I've never smoked, and yet I use these to hold all kinds of different things. I'm interested, what do you use your ashtrays, your vintage ashtrays for? If you don't smoke or have never smoked, drop it in the comments. This is pretty cool. Very substantial candle holder, 6128, again, made by Blenko. Just kind of show you what it would look like. Regardless, very pretty. Very substantial, 6128, first produced in 1961. I love these. Last but not least, I bought this on an online auction. It is amethyst color. I'll tell you a little bit about why that's kind of a special deal. The item number, Blenko 891. It's made in, you guessed it, 1989. It has most of the label, as you can see. Amethyst is, well, what's called amethyst color, which is kind of purple. Color is highly sought after, highly desirable. It's actually harder to make than some of the other colors. It has a lower threshold at which it hardens. So it's very difficult to work with. I really love this piece. Like I said, I got it online auction for a steal, and this is part of my personal collection. What is it? It's a little mini vase. You can put little, no, it's not a bank. The little slot on top, and you can put flowers in there. It's quite heavy too, and it sits real nice without tipping over. I included item numbers on some of them. If I did not mention it, why I presented it, I put it here or there, somewhere. And again, like I said before, the first two numbers is the year that it was first made. That doesn't mean that that item that I showed you today or any that you might find was actually made during that year. It's just when it was first made. Anyway, I really hope you enjoy this presentation and learn something new. Okay, it's a lot of really gorgeous Blenko glass. Absolutely beautiful. Thank you for tuning in. Happy Monday. Have a lovely week. If you like what you just saw and you want to see more of it, please hit like and smash that subscribe button. Right, Sam? Yeah, he says right.